Hi, I'm Jeff Hulett, CTO at Vektrex, and I'm the architect for the SpikeSafe series of current sources. They're used worldwide in reliability, LM80, and other photometric applications. Today, I'm going to talk to you about improving your overall accuracy in your light measurements. In the last webinar, we talked about the three different methods of light measurement, and we mentioned that the SpikeSafe can support all three methods at peak power. Now that you have the capability to do all three, the question becomes, which method is best? Well, let's take a look at a common test example that'll illustrate which one is best. It's an LI sweep with a continuous pulse measurement. Here we can see the sweep from low current to high current is pretty linear. This happens to be a yellow LED. We can do the same sweep with single pulse, and we see it's a little bit less linear. It's actually curved down and it ends about 25% below the continuous pulse. Again, the same sweep with DC mode, and now it's even more pronounced, the curvature. In fact, it's 70% down at the final highest current. So why is this happening? LEDs experience a significant drop in flux output because of junction heating. And in fact, we can take the plots and determine exactly how much heating is going on. Here you can see the points show the various endpoints of each measurement: continuous pulse, single pulse, and DC. And continuous pulse has very little heating, only a degree or so, and so its flux output is the highest of all three. So now its continuous pulse is obviously the best or most accurate measurement. But what do we need to know about continuous pulse? Well, continuous pulse is a little different from single pulse and DC, and that is that the current actually transitions up and down during the spectrometer integration time. And so the integration time incorporates one or a series of pulses rather than having the current on before the spectrometer starts. So what this means is that the up and down, the slope sides, are part of the measurement. Does this matter? Well, at first it might seem it doesn't, because geometrically the trapezoid shape has the same area as the square shape here. But in fact it does matter, and the reason why is because LED output is not exactly linear. Here's an example curve for a Cree XPE green LED, and you can see it curves quite far away from linear. At 50% current, you get 64% flux. So that curvature will yield an error in the overall measurement. If you do the math on the errors, you get some curves like this. Here's two sources plotted. One has a 2 microsecond rise time. That's typical of the SpikeSafe series. Another has a 30 microsecond rise and fall. That's more typical of common source meter instruments. And you can see as our pulse width gets shorter and shorter, the error due to this rise time gets more and more significant. At 100 microseconds, the 30 microsecond rise and fall has over a 3% error. That's pretty significant. And the industry recognizes that, and in fact, in the new TC263 testing standard, it specifies that you must use a current source that has a response time of a few microseconds. And that's because of these errors. So here's some examples of what you might look for. This is a SpikeSafe operating at a 12 watt power level. And you can see it has 1.3 microsecond rise time and a similar fall time. So that's very good. Here's another more powerful pulse. This one has 480 watts. And again, the rise time is under 2 microseconds. So quite good, nearly an ideal pulse. The final example is a 1600 watt pulse. This one has a slower rise time, 6 microseconds, but at a 200 microsecond pulse width, it still provides only a 1% error with this type of LED. As we saw in this webinar, the key to accuracy is to reduce your junction heating, and continuous pulse method is the best method for reducing junction heating. But if you're using continuous pulse method, you need a good current source. Go to Vektrex.com for more information about the SpikeSafe Performance Current Sources, and watch the next webinar where I'll talk about another way to improve light measurements through increased repeatability.